welcome you back to WCW Monday Nitro. Everywhere you turn. Hello there, beautiful. Everywhere you look. I'm seeing masks are everywhere. And I wasn't saying hello to you. There we go. But Bobby the Brain Heenan has joined us as we begin the second hour. And you're talking about electricity. But still, there's an underlying sick feeling we all have. The fact that we do not know where Sting is.
Well, it seems to me nobody knows where Sting is. Nobody's heard from Sting. Nobody's seen Sting. He's up to something.
And it's what everybody in the locker room is talking about.
Yeah.
And I don't think any of us expected to hear from Sting in terms of words, but an appearance would be nice.
At least we know one way or the other what's something.
You know, this is a homecoming of sorts for the man on the right of the screen there, Kevin Nash, now in the forefront. 3 years as a member of the Tennessee Volunteers basketball team back in Knoxville.
You're not kidding. He was...
You mean you had to volunteer to play basketball?
That's the name of their team, Brain.
The Volunteer State.
Don't you follow...
You never volunteer for anything. That's what I learned.
Yeah. So that's the Brain for you. You're right.
You wind up in this state.
Kevin Nash, a member of the Volunteer basketball team. Of course, this basketball program brought some great... to the NBA and some great athletes out of it, and not only the NBA and basketball, but the NFL and football. But as the state of Tennessee,
by the new,
be realistic, you know what's going to happen here if they hold true to form. Scott Hall is going to come out and do his little survey, but I think you can look around at the many faces and give you the answer to the survey. Yeah, they're going to chant NWO. But look at the faces. Look at the... And you see that overwhelming. The fans are behind Sting, and that means the fans are behind WCW, because that's what he represents.
Well, everybody's showing support wearing those Sting masks. That tells you something right there, what they feel for the guy.
Hey, yo. You probably heard by now that the NWO's doing a little survey in every town we go to. We want to know if you're with us or if you're against us.
Well, just look at the mask.
What do you think? So it's real, real simple. Did everybody here in Knoxville come to see WCW?
Oh yeah.
Or did everybody here in Knoxville come to see the...
Can spell here in Knoxville.
Looks like one more town for the bad guy.
Yeah, wrong again.
What's the deal with those tag belts?
You got the money, you can buy anything. That's the deal.
You know, we've been coming out here now for a year and a half, and you think by now that the WCW guys would learn. They would learn that if they mouth off to the NWO, they're gonna pay a price. Sting paid the price last week. That's right, you big goof giant. You paid the price. It's quite simple. If you're the WCW guys, you're the patsies. You're walking underneath the Dallas police station like Lee Harvey Oswald. And that's right, the NWO is Jack Ruby with a gunshot to the stomach. Go ahead, bring the lamb out to slaughter. Let's bring out the dude that lost to the chick. Let's bring out Disco, and let's get this show on the road.
Scott Hall, and already the numbers against the Disco Inferno. I'm told the Disco Inferno will come out in just a few moments, but we have to take a commercial break. Back with more live on Monday Nitro as the second hour's underway. Six. second hour off and underway here on WCW Monday Nitro. We are at the Civic Coliseum in Knoxville, Tennessee, a venue that was sold out. I was told it was sold out the very day tickets went on sale. And just today, WCW production came in with the cameras, the lights, the Nitro set, and we opened up a few more seats. So the thousands of fans can pack in here at the Civic Coliseum.
And a jam-packed crowd it is. You look all the way up at the top, and you see the fans standing all the way to the last row.
Well, this man here better forget about dancing and worry about what he's got in that ring.
He's the Rodney Dangerfield of World Championship Wrestling. No respect from anyone in the locker room, that dating back to the loss to Jacqueline.
You know, and he thought by holding onto the television belt that he could garner the respect and get the respect back, but then he lost the TV belt to Saturn. And that was that. But you know, there's our lady.
Talk about lack of respect. There's a story making its way around the locker room area that when Disco Inferno came into the building today in Knoxville, he asked where the restroom was at. And the response that he got was, which one?
Oh, my goodness. He has to face Scott Hall. And Brain, you brought up a good point. He has to be very careful. And you realize that when you face a member of the NWO, that you've got to be concerned about another man on the outside, but you can't change your game plan. You've got to go in the ring using what made you successful, and that makes it doubly tough.
Well, there's no doubt about that. And the Disco Inferno right here, he's got to worry about, forget about his hair getting mussed up. He's got to concentrate on Scott Hall. Forget about big Kevin Nash at ringside and all the NWO people in the back. Think about who you're wrestling. That's a big enough job.
Referee Billy Silverman trying to get in there, and there you see the Disco Inferno. And I really think that I respect him. Look at this. Look at what he's doing. Look at the aggressive nature that Disco Inferno is using against Scott Hall. Hall has had enough, though. Hello, Knoxville. You can hear that one all the way to the state capital of Nashville.
Probably change the name of this place to Knoxville.
And a running lariat that caught the Disco Inferno. Oh, and a right hand. Down he goes. Right now, the NWO looking good. But you know, when they look out among the thousands of fans here, they realize Sting Mask means that Sting is imminent. At least we know the date is looming, although we don't know where Sting is.
Or if and when we'll ever hear from him prior to Starcade.
That one sent the man neck first to the mat.
That was a message for the Giant right there, the choke slam from Scott Hall.
Yeah, let's not forget what happened a week ago. Actually, a couple of weeks ago, the Giant had his hand broken, and then they came in, they being the NWO, last week. Oh, my goodness, Kevin Nash factors the Disco Inferno on the outside. Kevin Nash came in, dressed as Sting a week ago with the baseball bat, broke apart the cast on the Giant's hand, and I'm sure injured the hand even further to the point to where the Giant is not here this week.
Just another example of the New World Order and the systematic destruction of World Championship Wrestling to date. Now taking it out on Disco Inferno in this double team effort by both Nash and Hall.
Well, you said the key point there, double team effort. They cannot do anything alone. And I challenge them to try to do something by themselves. Can't be done. Don't know how. Here he goes.
Time for the edge.
Outsider edge. Nowhere to go but down here, Brain.
And look at Nash on the floor enjoying it.
He's out.
Another win for the New World Order. They need to get all the wins they can because the biggest one is to come on December 28th. Remember what Hogan said. Hogan said, I am the NWO. I created the NWO. Therefore, a win by Sting, I think, would destroy all of that. But
life. Well, it has to. It has to be in the back of their minds, too. They know what Sting's capable of. And if we're wondering where Sting is, believe me, so are the NWO.
Coming up next, the Ultimo Dragon and Psychosis on Nitro. We'll be right back.